This is a Samsung A54 5G. The screen is being badly damaged on this device, so as usual, we are going to replace it with a new screen, and we got the replacement right here on our desk. Let's get it done. One day we are taking pictures of Spider-Man, but the next day we realize we broke our phone in the process. If this happened to you, don't worry, I'm here to help. We went and purchased our replacement screen along with the frame. It's only gonna add like $5 to $10 to this repair, but it's gonna look a lot better. To begin with, we need to remove the back glass on this Samsung A54 5G. For that, we are going to use our heating mat. Like I always said, if you don't have this type of equipment, you can also use a hairdryer or a heat gun. Let me turn this on. I'm gonna lay my phone down here, just like so, so the back of this phone gets a little warm. After that, I'm gonna use my razor blade along with this playing card. It's a plastic playing card. It's gonna help me to remove the back cover without breaking it. In other videos, I always said, if you don't feel comfortable working with this type of equipment, you can also use a suction cup or maybe some plastic razor blade. All right, I think this is hard enough. Let me just grab my phone, grab my razor blade, and start just digging in between the frame and the glass, just to create a baby gap, very little gap, so I can squeeze in my playing card just like so. After squeezing my playing card, I can just put my razor blade on the side. I can keep going with my playing card just like so. Remember, don't let this get cold, because the glue is just gonna stick back to it and it's not gonna be that easy to remove it. Keep warming it up as you please, because that way it's gonna come out easy and you're not gonna break. So we're gonna use the same technique to remove this back. You warm it up and then just try to slice the playing card along inside there. The glue sometimes on these phones is only in the edges, it's not in the middle, so that just gives us a better chance to remove this without breaking it. So like you guys can see here, I'm doing pretty good, and that also split from one of the sides, and I'm gonna keep going. I'm not gonna put any pressure to remove it. Now it came off loose, I'm gonna just pull it like so. If you see any other glue like this, you maybe pull the glue along, because you don't want to force that back glass out. And that's how you remove the back glass on your Samsung A54 5G. We have a total of 16 screws on this phone. Let's remove those. You are going to use the Phillips screwdriver for these. And that is the last one. Now I'm going to grab these two plastic trays and also remove them, and it's gonna come right off. That one also comes with the ear speaker, so be careful on that one not to break it. I believe the one on the bottom is also gonna have the loudspeaker as usual, as usually happen on these phones, as you guys can see right there. Okay, at this point also, I'm going to remove the SIM tray for this phone. Remember, we have our SIM card inside this phone, so let's just remove that for safety precaution. Anyways, we are removing this motherboard. If we don't remove the SIM card, we're gonna have problems. Remove the SIM cards, put it on the side. Recognizing phone parts is really essential for any repair. We have the battery right here in the middle, we have the charging port, and we have the motherboard along with the cameras. The long cable communicate the charging port, the LCD cable to the motherboard. It's very important to recognize all these parts. First thing, after we remove the screws on this phone, we are going to unplug the battery. That's a very important part of this repair. And now we are going for the cables. We have, like I just repeat, we have the big cable right here to the motherboard. Then we have the cable that communicates with the charging port. And the last right here, that is the connection for the LCD. Unplug that and you have this flex cable out. Now we're going to proceed and remove a single screw right here. Connected to the charging port, we have our fingerprint sensor. We are going to unplug the little cable so we avoid any further damage. Also, our LCD cable rests right on top of the charging port, so we need to unglue it. We have a little glue right here, so we get to remove this charging port. And let's work on that just now. We lift it from the top and it's gonna come just right off. What I do sometimes, I don't unplug these little antenna cables to avoid any further damage, because those parts sometimes are really, really fragile. So I leave it just like that and I move towards the top where our motherboard is resting. So I go ahead and unplug the front camera. It can come right off just like so. That's our front camera. And one single screw is holding our motherboard. Let's remove that. And now we can lift our motherboard using the same technique from the bottom to the top, and it's gonna come right off just like so. So we get these two pieces together by these cables. So I'm gonna leave those cables on and put it on the side and one piece. At this point, we have three little pieces that we need to remove out of this frame. We have the sensor for the fingerprint, we have the vibrator, and the biggest of all, the battery. To help to remove the battery, we don't need heat like before. It has a little pull tab right here. Let's see how this pull tab works. Let's try it out. First attempt to use our pull tab to remove the battery. Okay, it feels pretty strong. Let's use both hands. Okay, it came off. It is coming off just like so. It was not that hard. Even I had to use both of my hands to accomplish this battery removal. But nonetheless, I like it a lot better this way. Can we just pull this up? Yeah, we can remove this and maybe reuse it for our new screen. For the vibrator, we're gonna use my little tool right here. And there we go, the vibrator came off. I believe this fingerprint is very, very lightly thick. I'm gonna just squish my screwdriver right here on the side and lift it. Yeah, that's all it needed. Our housing is totally empty. We can bring the new one and compare it. We need nothing else from here. We have all the bottoms and our new housing, which is really, really cool. Let's put our old screen on the side, focus on the new screen. I'm gonna remove this cover for the camera. We now have our camera structure, and we also have one for the fingerprint. Let's try to install this little glue. We could install new glue on that, but if this one works, that would be really, really cool. So we have everything original. Okay, it seems like the glue is totally working. Very nice, very cool. And let's grab our battery and just lay it in there. Very nice. And we have our new battery, our battery installed and the new housing. And it's looking just like so. It's not gonna come out even if I try to pull it with my fingers, so it's nice and steady. Let's grab our vibrator and put it back on the new housing. At this point, I'm going to grab my motherboard charging port combo and install it back in this housing. Just like so, I start from the top and bring it to the bottom right there. Red cable goes on the bottom and the white cable is on the top. And this one, we're gonna squeeze this part. This part, we're gonna squeeze it right there in the hole and push it. And it's gonna just fall in place. Very nice, very nice. We got this cable. And we have we still have some double side tape right there where the LCD cable is gonna rest. Just bend it right there and put it back on place. Remember, we have our sensor that also we're gonna just install back, connect it to the charging port, and like so. Our phone is looking pretty nice right now, just like this. Still have a few things to install. We have our front camera that is plugged into the motherboard directly, and we're gonna bring our big flex cable that goes from the LCD. We're going to connect the LCD first. There we go. Gonna hear that nice click, nice click. And last one, the one on the top. All the electrical mechanical parts on these are mostly installed, and now we can go ahead and plug in the battery. Yeah, the battery is one of the last one that we're gonna put. Remember, we have two screws, one for the charging port and one for the motherboard. Let's install those. Everything is looking perfect, just in place. Now we install the loudspeaker and our ear speaker. Now we have 16 screws to install back. That is the last screw. We have right here our back glass that we just removed. We have this all glue on it. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove all this glue. Let's just pull the all glue out of this back glass. There is two ways we can glue this back into the phone. We usually use this liquid glue B7000. We apply it all the way around in the edges where the double side tape was installed and just lay it back and let it dry. And also we can use double side tape like this. We can put all the way around, and today I'm going to do that just because some people request using tape. We have this nice tape right here and we're going to use it. Just put it all the way around this phone like this. I can just lay down this tape and cut it over here. And what I do is, because you guys can see, I put longer pieces down here. I grab my razor blade and I cut it exactly where it should be, just like that. And that way we got a nice cut, round cut, because obviously with the scissor will be a little more difficult. So nice, we have our glue right there. Same thing on the top. I go and cut it like so, and we have our nice finish right here. Same thing I'm gonna do with the other side. You can cut it a little long, just like so. Many people don't, it's gonna have a hard time doing this kind of technique, but I just do it like so, and I always have fun doing this. Same thing, I use my razor blade and I count the little round part right there. Now this other side on the top. And now the tops or the middle parts, I'm gonna use the same technique. Just gonna start right there. And I can use my razor blade to cut it just right there. Same thing on the bottom. This is the best way to install this double side tape. I didn't see it anywhere on the internet that they use this type of technique. I was just like wondering how people do it, but like that's how I do it. All right, now we have beautiful and even double side tape all the way around our phone. Let's just remove this glue cover. They're really satisfying, to be honest with you guys. Really, really satisfying. Removing that glue cover. If you guys have maybe a different type of glue, if it's a little thinner, also works. It also works if it's, it doesn't have to be this wide. It also works good. All right, that's the last one. Okay, we have our glue already installed on the phone. We have our back glass right here ready. Make sure there is nothing in between our back glass and the phone, and just lay that last piece right here flat to give a better seal of the glue. You can always warm up a little bit this back glass. The glue always get a little bit stronger when you warm up the glue. It's just gonna stick better to any other surface, just to give it a little sealed like. Yeah, it gets a little warm and you can just press it. And this phone, it's gonna look so beautiful, nice and finished. So that's how you replace the front screen on your Samsung A54 5G. And don't forget, before we go, right here we have our SIM card. Look, it's even like covered. We're gonna peel that cover. Gonna peel that cover and insert our SIM card right there, and let's push our power button. Now our phone is coming on and it looks beautiful, just like it came from the factory. That's the good thing when you use this type of screens replacement already with the frame. They also come out like really beautiful repairs, and it's just gonna cost you like extra $5 to $10, and it's gonna just save you a lot of headache during the repair process. So all right guys, there we go. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon so don't miss any future videos. That's it guys, thank you for watching. I'll see you back on the next video. Bye now.